where the body?
What verse you at?
19.
Well, read the book, David.
And if they were all one member.
If they were all one member.
Where were the body?
Where were the body?
But now are they many members.
Now are they many members. I'm glad we ain't just one body as a physical human being. Because when you miss, we all miss. But I made up my mind, I'm coming if you don't. Because I know God is a rewarder of them that diligently seek Him. Not half-heartedly, not do it your way, not come when you want to. You'll never walk in the abundance of God. God said, I'm looking for somebody that will diligently seek me. My daughter preached a profound word, no more excuse. I don't even listen to him, no way. An excuse is justified to you.
Yeah,
it makes you
one
feel
body.
One body.
And the eye cannot say unto the hand.
And the eye cannot say unto the hand, read.
I have no need of you.
I have no need of you. Because I need every part. God need every part.
Amen.
That's why he called every part. And so we live in the day now, you just jump up and join churches. See, God don't want you comfortable, he wants you conformable. See, comfortable, you can sit in the church and still do your thing. Conformable is God make, break, and mold you. And then you start looking like Jesus. You know, everybody can sound like Jesus, but everybody can't look like him. Satan can sound like him. But he can't look like it.
Come on.
Oh. Ooh, God. Read the book, David.
Nor again the head to the feet.
Mm-hmm.
I have no need of you.
Uh-huh.
Nay, much more those members of the body which seem to be more feeble.
The ones who think you don't have more much to offer. Let me tell you what really make a ministry work. The people who working behind the scenes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Folks doing stuff for everybody to see them, guess what? Ain't nobody impressed with you. But when hell going in your life and you still show up and say, God, I'm here. Body tired, just got off work, but I'm here. You know why I preach this type of gospel? I was in one church for 15 years. You count on one hand how many times I missed.
Right.
Why you say that, Bishop? Because see, when you really in something, you faithful. You faithful. You available to God. Then guess what? You know why some of you jacked up? Look at your name and say, you jacked up.
You jacked up.
Because nobody can't teach you nothing.
Nobody can't teach you
nothing. But your smart self. You bound, but can't nobody teach you nothing. You can't put 2 feet in front of yourself, but can't nobody teach you nothing. Have I got you mad enough yet? See, when you get mad, you listen. You say, what that Negro gonna say next? Huh? Yeah. You ever seen somebody who bound, but they got all the answer? If you got all the answer, why the devil got you in captivity? Why the devil got you bound if you know so much? See, the Bible, folks says this, where there's knowledge, there's power. No. He that know the truth shall be made free. And they'll be free indeed.
Yeah.
And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall deliver you.
Yes.
Huh. Truth got me off drugs.
Yes.
Truth got me off alcohol.
Come on.
You know what? I have to yield and be taught by somebody.
Yes.
Jesus said, take my yoke upon you and stop walking in the church like you know.
All right.
You know scripture, but you're jacking it up. Sit down.
Hey.
Sit down so you can be taught. I'm preaching better than y'all
sound.
And so you'll go around in life trying to do it your own way. But guess what? You're going to come to a brick wall. And mama won't be in help you, daddy won't be in help. Folks you've been manipulating all your life, they ain't helped you. You're going to have to turn to the God of the church.
Yes.
Go to Ephesians 1:22. I'm about to let you go. Uh-huh.
When he raised him from the dead and set him at his own right hand.
Watch this. Read.
In the heavenly place.
Uh-huh.
Far above all principality and power.
Uh-huh.
And might.
Uh-huh.
And dominion in every name that is named.
Uh-huh.
Not only in this world, but also in that which is to come. And hath put all things under his feet.
He put what?
Oh.
All things under Jesus' feet. Watch this. Read.
And gave him.
And gave him.
To be the head.
To be the what?
Head.
You want to be the head, you get the right head. Watch this.
All right.
Oh, my God. Uh-huh. Watch this. Read.
Over all things.
Over all things.
To the church.
To the who?
Church.
Church, you don't know the authority and the ability and the power you have. Sit down here. Let me tell you something. Matter of fact, if you really walk with God and you make up your mind that I'm not going to walk slew-footed, I'm not going to be acting like I'm churchy in church and worldly in the world. But if you make up your mind to really sell out to the God of the church, which is Jesus Christ, he will give you power, he will give you dunamis, he'll give you strength. When you feel like giving up and you can't make it, the Holy Ghost has said, keep on going. You can do all things through Christ with strength in you. When you become faithful to God, no matter the obstacles and situations and circumstances come in your life, you got something on the inside that says, guess what? This won't last always. It's just a storm that coming in your life. I'm so glad. I hear the Bible say in Matthew, the 7th chapter, the 24th verse, a man built his house, and there was two men, and they built their house, and one built his house on a rock, and another built his house on sand, but the same storm came, and when the flood came and the storm came, the man that built his house on a rock, I'm not talking about crack cocaine, I'm talking about on Jesus, when the storm came, and the flood blew the upper house down, the man that built his life on Christ, still standing. I know why you've been married for 38 years. You built your marriage on Christ. I know why you've been standing and been preaching so long. Because you build your life on Christ. And when the hard things of life come, God is right there with you. The benefit of being in church and a powerful church. I hear the Bible say, in the Acts, the 12th chapter, they locked up James and some of the disciples, and they killed James. And the next day, they were looking to kill Peter. But the Bible said the church got the news, and they prayed without ceasing. Let me tell you something. God changes things. And if it don't change things, it will change you. It will give you strength to endure.
The lust of the eye and the pride of life. Stop wanting
so I want to please God. And so in pleasing God, I got to walk by faith in His Word.
Yes.
Not by how I feel. If the devil have somebody say boo to run you from church, they going to say boo boo. Because you going to go. Ain't nobody, at the church somebody said the same thing to you on your job. You went back the next day. It's crazy stuff about church hurt. Wherever you get hurt, it hurt. That's just Satan's excuse to get you out your rightful place. You've been hurt, you at the right church. God trying to make you. He don't make you at the church picnic. Y'all ain't too much barbecue for the devil to mess with you. You made in the church around the believer. You strengthened her and you made them. Because if you're at the right church, you're going to have a man or woman God just flat-footed tell you the truth.
Amen.
People been trying to be your friend.
Yeah. Right?
You can't tell me you love me and don't tell me truth.
Right.
I'm finna walk into a situation that'll get me hurt, but you so passive, you ain't going to tell me. You don't love me.
Right.
You don't love me. You may lust me, but you don't love me. Big difference. Well, read Hebrews 4 and 1 day. Would you read the book?
Let us therefore fear, lest a promise being left us of entering into His rest, any of you should seem to come short.
Watch this. Entering into God's rest is entering into His peace. See, you got peace with God when you got saved. But to have the peace of God, you got to walk in obedience. Huh? You got to walk in obedience to keep the peace of God. But when you got saved, you got peace with God. But to have the peace of God, it's going to take you humbling yourself and obeying. Oh, you think obedience and submission is a curse word? Yielding is a blessing. Because when you yield to the Spirit of God, He'll take you on trips you've never been.
Yes, sir.
And some things come in your life, you're going to need God to sustain you.
Yes.
Pastor Moshe said his family facing different things. And when your family, you love the church, but when it's your family, it even hit even deeper.
Yeah.
But guess who can take him through it? God.
Yeah.
Keep your mind stayed on Him. He'll keep you in what? My peace, Jesus said, I give to you. Not as the world give I unto you. Because if the world give it, guess what? They got a motive because they're giving you something to get something back.
Right.
But not God. God got to give you peace because He wants you to know what He walked in.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Look at your name. Say the benefit of being in a powerful church.
The benefit of being in a powerful church.
See, because you can't be in Christ and not be in His church. He said, I'm the head of the church. Well, I can serve God at home. You been. I get to that. I get to that. All you folk been fooled with that. Are y'all right? Read the book, David.
For unto us was the gospel preached.
Watch this. Unto us. I say this, unto us.
Unto us.
Watch this. What's the what?
Gospel preached.
Read.
As well as unto them.
See, we have some us and we have some thems.
Right.
Are you a us or a them? Unto us, the gospel, the good news will preach. As unto them. Watch the difference. Read.
But. The word preached.
But the word preached.
Did not profit them. Not being mixed with faith.
I don't care how we preach and teach. If you don't mix it with faith, you ain't got nothing coming.
All right.
So there's some us, and then there's some them. Us take it and walk by faith. Them hear it and go do their own thing. But it won't profit them because they didn't mix it with
faith.
Oh God!
In them that heard. For we which have believed.
But we which have believed.
Read. Do enter into rest.
Do enter into rest, as He said. Can I tell y'all something? Ain't no rest to the wicked. I used a lot, I wasted, and some of y'all can relate to this, waste a lot of time trying to have fun, oh, yeah. But would get myself in more bondage.
Yeah. Come on.
Uh-oh, I guess I'm the only one. Watch this, go to Hebrews 10. The benefit of being in a powerful